Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If x and y are real numbers, 5x squared plus 10y squared minus 12xy minus 6x minus 4y plus 13 equals 0, what are values of x and y? We have one quadratic equation containing two variables, x and y. In general, it is difficult to solve it because we don't have enough information. At least in general, we need two equations to solve for two variables. For this question, we do have an extra condition. Here, x and y are real numbers. How to solve this kind of question? First of all, we rewrite this given condition of this left-hand side. Consider this quadratic equation as an equation about y only. Just treat x as a constant. Factor y out. Consider this is a constant. So here, if we consider this is a quadratic equation about y, we have a equals 10, b equals negative 4 times 3x plus 1. The last part, that's a c. From the given condition, y is a real number. To solve this equation, we should have two real solutions. This implies the discriminant delta equals b squared minus 4ac is bigger than or equal to 0. The discriminant, this is the inside part of the square root of the quadratic formula. We already mentioned that this is A, this is B, this is C. We plug in those numbers into delta. B squared minus 4AC. Look at this part. Negative 4 squared, that's 16. 4 times 10, that's 40. Both you have 8 as a factor. Both sides we can simplify and divide by 8. Then we have 2, 3x plus 1 squared minus 5 times 5x squared minus 6x plus 13, which is bigger than or equal to 0. Continue to simplify the left-hand side of this inequality. We have negative 7x squared plus 42x minus 63 is bigger than or equal to 0. We can factor negative 7 out. The remaining part form a perfect square, which is x minus 3. Both sides divide by negative 7 because that's a negative. We have to change the direction of this inequality sign. This implies x minus 3 squared less than or equal to 0. Anything squared must be bigger than or equal to 0. So left-hand side is less than or equal to 0, and at the same time is bigger than or equal to zero, combining both conditions. This implies x minus 3 must be equal to zero. X minus 3 equal to zero means x equals 3. We find the value of x. The remaining part is to find the value of y based on x equals 3. This is a given condition. From this given condition, we can replace x by 3. Three squared is 9, 9 times 5 is 45, and replace all x here, by 3. We have this quadratic equation about y. Continue to simplify the left-hand side. We have 10y squared minus 40y plus 40. Both sides divided by the common factor 10. We have y squared minus 4y plus 4. The left-hand side is a complete square, which is y minus 2 squared equal to 0. This implies y equals 2. We find the only answer is xy equals 3, 2. This is the answer. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.